Welcome to this Sunday service. Please join us as you worship from home. Join us so that we may worship the Lord together, that we may praise Him together, that we may call upon Him and bring our needs and petitions to Him. Let us pray. Our Lord, in the name of Jesus Christ, we come before you this morning to glorify your name and to praise you, to honor you and say that you are our God, there is no other, and there will never be one. We glorify your name and we give you thanks for the gift of life, the gift of yet another day which you have given us today, the gift of good health, O Lord, the gift of families. Our Lord, may you be with us. May your Holy Spirit speak to us this morning, that we may learn more and more about Jesus, that we may praise him, that we may always remember that he is the one who died to save us. Guide us, teach us, and be with us. For this we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Brothers and sisters, let us hear the reading for the day.
Our reading is taken from the book of John, chapter 10, beginning to read at verse 1. John, chapter 10, beginning to read at verse 1. I tell you the truth, the man who does not enter the sheep pen by the gate, but climbs in by some other way, is a thief and a robber. The man who enters by the gate is the shepherd of his sheep. The watchman opens the gate for him, and the sheep listen to his voice. He calls his own sheep by name and leads them out. When he has brought out all his own, he goes on ahead of them, and his sheep follow him because they know his voice. But they will never follow a stranger. In fact, they will run away from him because they do not recognize a stranger's voice. Jesus used this figure of speech, but they did not understand what he was telling them. Therefore, Jesus said again, I tell you the truth, I am the gate for the sheep. Whoever came before me were thieves and robbers, but the sheep did not listen to them. I am the gate. Whoever enters through me will be saved. He will come in and go out and find pasture. The thief comes only to steal and kill and destroy. I have come that they may have life and have it to the full. I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. The hired hand is not the shepherd who owns the sheep. So when he sees the wolf coming, he abandons the sheep and runs away. Then the wolf attacks the flock and scatters it. The man runs away because he is a hired hand and cares nothing for the sheep. And this is the word of the Lord.
We thank God for his word this morning. For these are words that were spoken by Jesus Christ himself. He spoke to his disciples and talked about something that everybody could understand. Indeed, we can say that Jesus was really a super communicator because he knew where to touch when he wanted to send a message to the people. We can see that he used a narrative or an imagery of a shepherd. A shepherd, a life that they were used to. A life that they knew about. Where shepherds would go out and look after the sheep. They would take out the sheep, take them to green pastures, take them to the watering points, and bring them home. And when he brings them home, they go through the gate that is well designated for them. We see that in the olden times, even in the African culture, shepherds had a pen on an area that they had set aside for their goats and sheep. And they would have a particular gate that they would use, either for bringing them in or out. We see a similar thing being talked about in Psalm 23. Psalm 23, a well-known psalm which says that the Lord is my shepherd, I lack nothing. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside quiet waters. He refreshes my soul. He guides me along the right paths for his name's sake. Praise the Lord. Indeed, Jesus brings the imagery of a shepherd again, just like the psalmist sang in Psalm 23. And he talks about the sheep, he talks about the gate, and he talks about the shepherd, and then adds above those the thief, the robber, and those who use different ways to the sheep. He taught that the shepherd knows and calls his sheep by name. So to the sheep, he is not a stranger, neither are the sheep strange to him. He takes care of them. When he comes to the pen and walks to the gate, they come close to him because they know that he is the one who takes care of them. He is the one who feeds them. He is the one who takes them to the watering point. When and if they are injured, he carries them home. He lifts them up and carries them. When the little ones are unable to walk the long distances as they go to feed, he lifts them up, holds them close to his chest, and takes them home. So when we hear about Jesus being the shepherd, being the one who keeps the gate to keep us as the sheep safe, then we know the direction we want to take. We know that we want to follow Christ. Then what we see in the scripture today, in verse 7, Jesus says, I am the gate. Therefore, Jesus said again, very truly, I tell you, I am the gate for the sheep. All who have come before me are thieves and robbers. Those who have taught the wrong teachings, those who have taught against the teachings of Christ, are actually thieves and robbers. He says that I am the gate for the sheep, and any other door or any other way that you may use to God is false. This morning, are we using the gate of Christ? And then Jesus said that anybody else who comes against my word is a thief and a robber. We have seen thieves and robbers in the name of preaching the gospel of Christ, but they come with their own doctrines, with their lies, and sometimes we follow them. In verse 14 of the same scripture, we read, I am the good shepherd. I know my sheep, and my sheep know me. Who am I? Who are you? Jesus says he knows his sheep. Does he know you? Does he know me? And what does it mean then? But Jesus, being the shepherd, gives salvation to his sheep. He gives salvation to his sheep. What kind of salvation are we talking about? When one goes to tend to the sheep, or you take your sheep to graze, then you have to be there and ready to take care of them. He said that if the wolves come, then the shepherd will be ready to deal with the wolf to save the sheep. But a bad shepherd will run away. He calls himself the good shepherd. He gives us salvation, salvation in our hearts. He also gives us sustenance in life. He gives us provisions in life. When we call upon him, he hears us. Just as a shepherd will hear the sheep, a shepherd walks around the pen to see which sheep may be hurting. And if he finds one that is limping, he will pick it up, inspect the legs, inspect the hooves, and see whether there is a problem, and we'll deal with it. The same thing he does for us. The same thing he does to us. Verses 10, which is the key verse, because today's reading and today's sermon is based on living an abundant life in Christ. Living an abundant life in Christ. Verse 10, he goes on to say, the thief comes only to steal and kill and destroy. To kill, steal, and destroy. The thief has nothing good for us. But I have come that they may have life and have it to the full. And other versions will say, have life abundantly. What is abundant life? What are we talking about when we say that one is having life in abundance? Having life to the full. Sometimes we think those who have life to the full are those who have a lot of money, those who have big cars, those who have personal aeroplanes. No. Abundant life is about satisfaction in our hearts. It is about the true feeling of being associated with Christ. And it is also the blessed assurance that Jesus is ours. He is our shepherd. He is the gate that we go through as we go to God. Abundant life. Well-fed sheep. Sheep that have been taken to green pastures. Sheep that have been taken to the right places. Sheep that have been well watered. They have been given enough water, and so they feel well. Sheep that have been treated if they are unwell. Sheep that have been given dewormers, those which have worms. Sheep that have been put on maybe some, the way we fasten the legs when they break, they have been taken care of. The good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. We know what Christ did. Christ laid his life for us. Christ came. Christ suffered for what we ought to have suffered ourselves. We ought to have been punished for our sins. We ought to have suffered for our sins and died. But he came. He came and gave his life as a good shepherd, that I could be set free and be told, go, you're innocent. Nothing is written against you. The same thing about you and I. What provisions is God giving us through Jesus Christ? What provisions is the sheep like me receiving from God? There are physical provisions. Provisions of food. Provisions of good health. Psychological provisions where I have good thoughts, and even when things are tough, I'm able to have straight thinking. Spiritual salvation. Knowing and having that blessed assurance that when I call upon him, he will hear me. That just like sheep, if I go astray, he will come for me. Remember Jesus said that a shepherd will go back to the bush to go and look for one sheep that is lost and leave the 99. So we are assured that when and if we get lost along the way, the Lord will be with us. The Lord will come for us and fetch us from the lost places. When we are ridden with diseases, when the diseases come, we know he will come, that we may have life and have it in abundance. Sin is something that really comes our way. We sin, for we say that if we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. So when we sin, because it's not if, then the salvation of Christ comes. And we are able to sit and ask God, please, Lord, forgive me. May that blood that was shed be upon me, that I may be saved. Remember what we have read in Psalm 23, that we shall enjoy the presence of the Lord, even when our enemies have set traps. The Lord will set a table for us in front of them. Even at this time of COVID-19, even at this time when we have to go covering our mouths with masks every time, the Lord will be with us. The Lord will come to our salvation. Remember what he said, Psalm 23, verse 5 and 6, that you prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil, my cup overflows. Surely, your goodness and love will follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Are we ready to dwell in the house of the Lord? Are we ready this morning to give our lives to the Lord, that he may have full control, just like the shepherd has control over the lives of the sheep? And he says that the bad shepherd usually runs away, but a good shepherd lays his life. Can you think about those people, even us pastors, who have failed to lay their lives for their sheep, for the congregants, and the only thing is waiting for the sheep to lay their lives for them? This morning, I would like you to take a few moments, a few quiet moments, as you reflect on the love of God, as you reflect on Christ, as you reflect on the way that you got to Christ. When you pray, whom do you pray to? Jesus said that I am the gate for the sheep, and those who come through me will get to the Father. This morning, let us remind ourselves how to go to Christ, how to use Christ as our Savior. And this morning, I would like us to say a prayer together, a prayer that will bring us closer to God, a prayer that brings salvation. I know at this time, we may become complacent in our homes because we don't go to church, because we wake up and every Sunday is like any other day, and so our worship may start going down. But this is the time that we need to call upon the Lord. This is the time that we must pledge our allegiance to Christ. This is the time to say that I want to follow Christ all the days of my life. This is the time to invite Christ into our lives. Remember, Christ says that I am knocking at the door, and whoever opens for me, I will come in and dine with him. Brothers and sisters, are you ready to open your hearts for Christ? Are you ready to invite Christ into your lives today? That he may come and reign in your heart. That he may come and be the shepherd of your heart. That he may come and keep the gate. For he is the good shepherd. For he is the true shepherd. The one who cares for. Meditate on his word. Meditate on what he says. And join me in this prayer. Please join me and pray together. Dear Lord Jesus, I know that I am a sinner. I have used the wrong gate many times, and I ask for your forgiveness. I believe you died for my sins, and invite you to come into my heart and into my life. I ask you to be my shepherd from today on in my life. Lord, take control of my life. Take control of my heart. Take control of my thoughts. Take control of my family, Lord. May you be in charge of everything I do. May you lead me to the green pastures which you know best. For when I walk alone, I will be lost. If I walk alone without you, I will not make it. Lord, I want to trust and follow you. And I want you to be my Lord and Savior. This morning, I ask that, Lord, you change me. I ask, Lord, that since you know me by name, Lord, call me. Lord, if I'm going astray, call me by name. For you say you know my name. And you say that, Lord, you see the tears that flow from my eyes. That you hear every word that I speak. And Lord, you will come to my salvation. For you came that I may have life and have it in abundance. Lord, take control. Lord, take charge. And I give myself away. I give myself to you that you may use me the best way that you want and the best way that you know, Lord. Guide me, Father, and teach me. For I pray in Jesus' name. Dear brothers and sisters, that's a prayer of salvation. It's a prayer of inviting Christ to be in our hearts. It's a prayer of inviting him to rule in our homes. It is a prayer of inviting him to be our shepherd, to be the gatekeeper in our marriages, to be the gatekeeper in our children's lives, to be the gatekeeper in our country, to be the gatekeeper in the world. So we have invited Christ. Let's wait patiently upon him. Let us pray as we close. Our Father, in Jesus' name, we thank you for the word that you have spoken to us. Jesus, as you spoke to your disciples, we have heard you clearly. And we ask you to be our shepherd. We ask you to be the gate that we pass through to the Father. We thank you, Lord, and glorify you, for we know that you care for us. Our Father, guide us. May we never get lost. May we never lose our way through the wrong gates. We know you care. Reach out to all those who are in need. Reach out to your sheep that are going through a difficult time. Heal their wounds. Water them, Lord. Give them pastures. For this we pray in Jesus' name. And Lord, may you accept the offerings that will be given by your people. May you sanctify them. May you bless them. Our Lord, may you increase even those who give and those who don't have, so that they can have enough for themselves and to bring to your house. For we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Brothers and sisters, let us pray for these first fruits that have been brought by one of us. It is from their farm. Let us pray. Thank you, Lord, for these first fruits that have been brought by your servant. Our Lord, it is you who has enabled them to farm on their gardens and their farms, and you have given them this produce. Our Lord, they have seen it fit to come and give this to your house that it may be used, O Lord. We pray that you will bless that farm which produced this. We pray that you will bless the owner. We pray that you will bless the workers on that farm. May you increase them. May you, Lord, give them tenfold and even more. And Father, may you remind us also to keep bringing our first fruits for more blessings from you. Father, remember them when they call upon you and grant them more. For we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. And now, people of God, may the Lord bless you. May the Lord keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. May he turn his face towards you and give you peace. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen. May you have peace to love and serve the Lord. In Jesus' name, amen. Remember that we shall be giving our offerings through the paybill number. And may the Lord bless you and keep you. Amen.
Each tear that falls and hears me where.